Okie dokie. Well, I hope we don't get eaten by the shark, but the goal is to follow the wreckage to find the ship. Don't do it, Sharky. Oh god, Sharky, don't do it. You don't want me. I don't even think I taste that good. Yeah, I don't think the shark can come in. Oh god, the shark can come in! Get out of here! No, Sharky, no! Sharky's coming in! Where the hell's that switch? Bad shark. Bad shark. Oh, thank God. I really don't know if the shark can come in here, but I didn't think he could come down. Oh, God, that was frightening. Seems to be safe. What? Where the fuck did you come from? You have to be careful, because I don't think you can come back to this area.
Uh-huh.
But there's a trap door in the middle, and once you fall through, I'm pretty sure you can't come back up.
Uh-huh.
Another shotgunner down there. Oh, what the hell? Screw it. Those guys are freaking brutal. Yeah, I think it's just too high to be able to jump back up. That's probably too high to single jump. Yeah. Whoever freaking designed this room was an asshole. Didn't have to make it this complicated. Yeah, I think you're supposed to do a running jump from here to do, slides. Or not. Yeah, but I don't think you can jump from here, right? Yeah, can't do that. Can you get it from this side? No, it should be the same distance, right? Oh, okay. Never mind. Yeah, duh. I guess it's worth noting as well that all the ship levels, the ship is upside down. So we are technically walking on the ceiling for the next like 3 or 4 levels. Yeah, these are annoying. They're time gates. And I'm gonna save it here. Just in case I didn't have enough time, which this is not looking good. It's close. You have to re-pull the switch, I'm pretty sure. Yep. But the switch I just pulled there, right above the fire, that one's not timed. And then that switch lowers the second set of flames. But I'm trying to remember which switch opens that secret door there. Because that switch, I'm pretty sure that switch just opens that door, but maybe not. Maybe it actually does open the secret door. And the door opens by itself. Yeah, I like how they put all these steel beams too, so every time you run you have to jump. Oh, there it is. That's what I was looking for. Makes it just a little bit more difficult, you know? This part's not all that enjoyable either. God dang it. Nope. Well, the shark was pretty nice. Didn't give us too much difficulty there. Now, I don't remember if we need to pull the early flame or the late flame first. We'll try it this way, and if it doesn't work, we'll do it the other way. I wish they didn't cut to that quick view though, because it's kind of disorienting. Okay, they're both still out. Still out? Okay, so that must have been the right-ish way. I was just curious to see. Yeah. Yeah, that was the right way. If you do it the other way, the flames come on too quickly. Be a switch here somewhere. There it is. Get the hell off of me, you little jerk. Thank you. I may have underestimated the amount of time this would take, so probably have to reload. Oh no, the gold statue's there too. Well, those are pretty quick secrets, though. We got them all pretty early on in the level, I think. But now we kind of know where we're going, so this should go a little faster. Pick up the secret first. Perfect. All three. Just a touch of fall damage, not too bad. You do have to be careful in these areas though, because if you fall through unexpectedly, you can definitely take just instant death from fall damage. Those are all too steep. I think we have to go down here then. There's two passageways there. I don't remember which one's which. Yeah, I don't think it matters though, in what order you do this stuff. I could be wrong though. So that opened a trap door and dropped all the shit into this room. Oh, I think we have to go back up. If I remember correctly, this is empty right now.
Yep.
Because this is how we finish the level. I thought we had to go back up to the floor above because there's another switch we have to hit up there. I just couldn't remember for certain. But I don't think we can go back up that way. It's too high. And now these are separate rooms? Maybe they were separate rooms before. This is the one we came down in, I believe. I think. Maybe not. Might have been the other one. No, this is actually the right one. Yeah, this was the one I think we originally came down in. I don't think there's anything else here. I am curious what's... Is there anything up here? Or did I already do that? This was the... Is this the first thing I did? Alright, what's this switch do? Oh, we have to do both. Yep, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. So we actually did have to use both entrances. But I don't think you could get to that one until you did the bottom one first. Likewise, you couldn't get to the other entrance without doing the bottom one too. Should be a harpoon guy. We're just gonna go past him real quick. Oops. Oh god, I forgot about this part. Jesus Christ. Fucking shotgunners. Yeah, I thought the level ended in that swimming passageway, but that sucks. Now we're gonna have to repeat all that shit again. Aw, damn it, I didn't save at all. Son of a bitch. Thank you. Yeah, that's my bad. But this should go pretty quick. So that's number one. Carefully navigate. This time, save it. And get the freaking shotgun ready. Don't do it, bitch. God, that guy is freaking brutal. I mean, those guys are deadly. Next level is the Maria Doria. One of my all-time favorite levels. Wait, no. We're not quite there yet, are we? That's not going to show me. No, we're on living quarters, I believe. No. No, no, we're on the right one. Yeah, Maria Doria. Yeah, living quarters is next. I don't think so. Yeah, it's nice how they put this large medkit here because they're like, oh, don't worry, you're going to get some free health. When in actuality, they're going to make you use that health immediately. But I will save it here. Oh, that's good. At least I didn't die. I didn't know whether or not that was going to kill me because I already lost some health, but they basically force you to take massive fall damage. And I think for the people who run this, oh, two little meds, that's nice. I think for the people who do the no loads, no meds runs for these games, I think this is actually one of the harder levels for them because you start off with a lot of damage at the beginning and then it's really difficult just because of the enemies. To make it through without having a med kit. I can't remember here. I know eventually we have to come here to do the circuit fuses or whatever they are, but I don't know if we have to come here initially or not. This freaking room's a nightmare too. This is just a hard level in general. I don't think there's anything back here. Yeah, circuit breakers. We need three of them. I don't think I noticed that before, but this is actually a pool. I just happened to notice the diving board there. But yeah, that's kind of cool. The railing for it or whatever. think there's a shotgunner up here too. We're getting there, Laura. Keep going. Almost got it. Almost. There you go. It's just a hard freaking level. Yeah, because people run no loads, no meds, all secrets, so I think this is definitely one of the hardest levels. Oh shit, there's another shotgunner? Jesus Christ. That's insane. This level's a nightmare. Go ahead and use one of these guys. Should be a guy. He might be in the other room, actually. They may not be loaded in yet. Yeah, you gotta push this one too. This is put here just a freaking screw you over. Maybe the guy I'm thinking of, there should be a guy and a dog, but I think they're behind this other room here. Or not. You technically don't have to do this because the passageways are open now, but oh, there's really no enemies here. I swore there was at least one. It's a key. Oh, maybe that's what I was thinking of. Didn't load in until quite later there. Oh yeah, forgot about that guy. Look how he walks right through that wall. What a nice guy. Another part that's force damage. So the problem is we have to get here. So you have to walk through just a hair of glass to be able to get that ledge grab.
Uh-huh.
Although, I guess if you're crafty enough, if you walk back here, you might be able to figure out how to get that to work from back here. You could probably do it, but... I don't think you dropped anything. See, this part's funny, because when I first played this, me and my dad, we got stuck for the longest time on this very part here. Because if you look over here, there's one of the circuit breakers. And for the life of us, we could not figure out how to get to this little section. It didn't look like there was any other trap doors. Didn't look like there was any openings. And I mean, we spent probably days trying to figure this out. And then it eventually dawned on us that, because if you look over here, there's a button. And as we progress through the level, you come to that little passageway there. It dawned on us that you just have to hit this button again, and it reopens the passageway. It's so simple. So simple. So there should be... Yeah, I think it's over here. There's only one way to get up here. I don't think there's anything over here. And this isn't super obvious either, because it looks like it's closed off, but you can definitely ledge shimmy. And I don't actually know if the guy that I killed over here has anything, but I guess I can go check it out. Oh, he did have some automatic pistol ammo. Oh no, you actually have to come this way. Yeah, here's the first circuit breaker. I guess we can use the Uzis for a little while. Got a lot of Uzi ammo. Just an empty room, I believe. It's such a dumb room. That's worth a try. So we've got two, no. We've got one statue. Can't really remember where the other two are. Oh, this is a passageway, yeah. So we actually want to pull this.